And hey guys, welcome back. And I'm sorry, it's been kind of a hibernation sort of time lately. And it's been a little bit long while since I did a last video, I guess about a week or so, or longer. But anyway, I'm here with the next part of Godzilla-thon, and this part I've been wanting to do probably the most ever since I started Godzilla-thon, and that is Godzilla vs. Biollante. So this movie actually is a bit of a sequel, almost a direct sequel, in fact, to their movie Godzilla 1984, because it does take place only 5 more years afterwards. And although I did apparently give you misinformation in the previous review, Godzilla is not dead. In fact, he does rise from the volcano. Which, when you think about it, makes sense. Now think about this. He resurrected from a volcano in Godzilla 1984. So wouldn't it make sense that he would resurrect again from a volcano in Godzilla vs. Biollante? Well, he does. And the government has to deal with it once again. Although an important thing to note is that they start to realize that Godzilla actually can't die for a certain sort of reason. And that is because of the nuclear power that he's able to absorb, there is something inside his body that is able to regenerate him. Which is a theme that would be carried on even further on into the further years to come. But this is where it has its roots. And speaking of roots, they decide, well, the only way to take care of that is by modern medicine. And so they devise a virus to go into Godzilla and totally cancel it out. And what they do is they get a botanist to work on it for them. Now for the first like third of this movie, it doesn't feel like a Godzilla movie. It's really strange. Because you have all this espionage going on with this other country or organization or something that's trying to get this thing from the Japanese government in order to, I don't know, do what with, but the thing is, they've got these assassins, and they're going around, and they're shooting people, and it's weird, but it just doesn't feel like a Godzilla movie at all. It's just like, this is a spy movie from the 80s, and it just happens to have Godzilla in it a few times. But that's not to say that Godzilla does not appear in it very much later, and he does, because he starts to wreak havoc on Tokyo, of course. I mean, they did just try to kill him. Now this botanist that I mentioned earlier, he actually was originally working on the plan when his laboratory was bombed, killing his daughter inside. Bombed by, who knows, these spies from some country who doesn't want Japan to be able to, you know, be independent of them or something like that. Hint, hint, America? I don't know. That would be weird. But anyways, that is what happens. And so he gets all disgruntled and sad and stuff. But he does decide to take a few pieces of skin captured from the remains of the last Godzilla battle, and inject it into a rose. Later, they see that this rose has grown and has become a giant toothed rose, which of course is Biollante. Now, Godzilla comes and destroys it because he senses that it's part of him, and for some reason that ticks him off, and he completely obliterates it because it's a rose. Come on. You wouldn't think Biollante, a rose, would be able to put up much of a fight against Godzilla, and of course it doesn't. Or does it? The acting on this movie is just great. I gotta say, it's really interesting. Now, you want to get the original Japanese version, and I really think that's the only version out there right now, but I mean, it's just, the acting's really good. I mean, it's got some cheesy quirks in it, and you can definitely see that there's a Western influence from the 80s ways of doing things. But it's still really good, I think. I think these characters were very convincing and very well done, I gotta say. This is also when we first get introduced to the character of Miki Sakuza, or whatever her last name is. Miki, anyway, you know, the girl with the ears. They kind of stick out. I don't know, that's how I know her. Anyway, she's a psychic, and she also is able to kind of communicate with Biollante the plant, which in turn makes her very useful because she knows when Godzilla's going to be coming, and that she does very well. And so all of them are really good, all the characters are really well done, but Miki actually will be a returning character throughout the whole Heisei era, which is kind of gives it sort of a binding sort of feel, and I love that about the Heisei era. And as I mentioned before, Godzilla does want to give a final blow to Tokyo, but he's suddenly stopped by Biollante, who has now become sort of a movable plant with a giant reptilian head. Yes, you heard me right, a giant reptilian head. It actually does look like a rose that swallowed Godzilla, and I mean, he's got kind of the spikes in the back and everything, and it's really cool. I think it's one of the coolest monsters from the Heisei era myself. And of course, after a huge battle, Biollante is kind of destroyed, he becomes particles and flies up into the air and stuff. And of course, the doctor has to do something romantic, like see his daughter in the sparkles, and you can take it or leave it. I don't really know what all that's about. But anyway, it does make you feel good after a sort of a grim storyline. Godzilla goes back to the sea, assuming to recover or something like that. And that's pretty much the end of this movie, leaving itself very open for a sequel, which indeed there would be many. Of all the Godzilla movies out there, I'm pretty sure this is the least seen of them. I think it's least seen than Godzilla Raids Again. For one thing, it hasn't had an American release since VHS. And for another, people just don't really talk about it. I mean, you hear a lot about Biollante, but have you actually ever seen the movie? It's really good. I do definitely recommend you seeing it. In fact, it's probably one of my favorites from the Heisei era. It's an odd choice, I know, but I definitely think you should check it out. But the next movie would definitely be one of the most infamous of the Heisei era, or should I say famous, because it is really quite good. And it's probably the most seen Godzilla movie in the world, going straight from the least to the most. Yeah, it's weird, but that's how it works. And I gotta say, I'm looking forward to showing it to you guys, and I'm pretty sure you all know what it is. But until then, this was Godzilla vs. Biollante. I've been Creature Hunt Guy, and I'll see you later.